Good evening. I'm David Copperfield. Welcome to Congregation Near Tamid and tonight's Tikkun Olam Award Virtual Gala. Thank you for joining us and for your continued support for Congregation Near Tamid. What a wonderful creative synagogue with innovative and inviting programs, with the coolest rabbi and the most talented cantor. Now it's my pleasure to introduce you to the host of tonight's gala, Jeff Libo.
Thank you, David. I am honored to host this year's annual fundraising event and to celebrate special honoree Jackie Rosen from Synagogue to Senate. We have an exciting and entertaining evening ahead, so sit back, relax, and enjoy. And now please welcome two incredible people here at Congregation Ner Tamid, Rabbi Sanford Axelrod and cantor Jessica Hutchings.
Shalom and welcome to Congregation Ner Tamid. My name is Rabbi Sanford Axelrod, and I have the pleasure of being the spiritual leader of this synagogue for the past 33 years. Who would have thought when I arrived in February 1988 that this small community of some 60 families would grow to become the largest synagogue in the state of Nevada? Now it's my pleasure to introduce my co-clergy, cantor Jessica Hutchings.
I am delighted to be with all of you tonight at our virtual event, and I look forward to the time when we can be together in person very soon.
Over the course of the evening, you will hear our story. With pride and joy, you will see how we've literally touched the lives of thousands of people in Clark County. It's a story of which I am very much proud of, and I thank you for your support of our synagogue and the values that we embrace. And now, in the spirit of Jewish tradition, Cantor Hutchings and I would like to offer a very special invocation.
We are together, though we're apart, we can reach out with all our heart. Hine matov umanaim, free from fear and illness, it is our dream. Shevet achim gam yachad, we ask for healing, Adonai our God. We look around, we know you're there. Grant us comfort, grant us care.
Rabbono Shalom, O source of light and light, we feel your presence and are grateful for this opportunity to gather together to celebrate an individual, Senator Jackie Rosen. She has devoted her life in service to you and to our country. We ask your blessings upon her as she leads our country during trying times. Bestow upon her wisdom and patience, fortitude and courage. Let her stand tall not only with pride, but indeed as she pursues the path of Tikkun Olam. Let us honor her by partnering with her in this great task of all people to make our world a better place. Hand in hand, heart to heart, apart yet together, our values bring us together in an unshakable trust.
We are together, though we're apart, we can reach out with all our heart. Hine matov umanaim, building this community, it is our dream. Shevet achim gam yachad, we ask for healing, Adonai our God. We look around, we know you're there. Grant us comfort, grant us care. Grant us comfort, grant us care.
And let us say, Amen.
Thank you, Rabbi Axelrod and Cantor Hutchings, for that beautiful invocation. There are special guests joining us tonight to help celebrate and show their support for Congregation Ner Tamid and all they do to enrich the lives of the congregation and our community throughout the year. We're hoping that you will show your support as well. To make a donation during tonight's fundraising event, text the number on your screen or visit the website below. The tagline here at Congregation Ner Tamid is a special place to belong. CNT is a dynamic and diverse place with creative services, wonderful activities, and programs for people of all ages and interests. Let's take a look.
Ner Tamid is an eternal light. The Spirit of God here in the desert, just like days of old, burns bright.
I think it's a perfect way to describe this community because we truly are an eternal light, not only to Las Vegas, but to each and every one of our congregants.
Congregation Ner Tamid is a Reformed synagogue community. It started in 1974 because there was a felt need in Las Vegas for the practice of Reformed Judaism. And during the course of that time, it grew from a small group of friends and people to become the largest synagogue in the state of Nevada with well over 600 families.
Reformed Judaism, to me, is informed choice. We know Judaism, and we're going to choose how to utilize it in our lives, how it best fits.
For us, it means that we are creatively free to express what it means to be Jewish.
We celebrate Shabbat, and we celebrate all the holidays. We have things like pop-up Shabbat and drum circles, and we celebrate in the best way we know how. We have a very high percentage of interfaith families, and I think the reason for that is because they know that for a bar mitzvah, or baby naming, or a wedding, anybody, no matter their race, their gender, the color of their hair, it doesn't matter. You are welcome here.
And so there are people who belong to our congregation and who don't, who come here just to learn.
Our tagline is a special place to belong. The reason that it's so special is because of the music. It is something that penetrates the whole space on a Shabbat, that it is the old and the new coming together, that it is the children singing on the bima and the grandparents clapping along, and that we just join together in joyous song that connects us to the people of our past.
We want to make Judaism fun. We want people who come here to feel like they have found a home, that this is the place where, if they're going to be Jewish, this is the place they want to be Jewish.
I think people know that this is a place where the door is always open. You have a cantor and a rabbi who will be there by your side for every prayer, every simcha, every sorrow. There's always somebody here for you at Ner Tamid.
We're about making the world better and about empowering everybody who comes here who seeks to be Jewish, and we're here to accompany them on their Jewish journey.
Good evening. I'm Gerald Gordon, president of Congregation Ner Tamid. When our founders had to decide upon our name, they chose congregation, not temple, because their vision was a gathering of individuals and families as a congregation. My family has been part of this congregation for more than 40 years. A congregation that is inclusive, engaging, spiritual, and committed to developing relationships through diversity. As congregants, we are committed to serving and helping one another, and are equally committed to serving and helping our community. As such, while we occupy a marvelous campus, we are defined by our membership, not by the buildings we occupy. And over the next hour, we are excited to share our story.
Anytime our congregation can join together with others, we get to know people from other congregations and communities. And so we're not just a Jewish community that's kind of hidden behind the walls of a synagogue, but we find that there's a real power and strength in combining our voices together.
It's important for us to involve ourselves with the outside community because in Judaism we have always done that. We're not so insulated that we ignore what's going out in the general community because let's face it, what happens in the general community affects all of us.
So there was a time when there was an organization called the NCCJ, and that was our local chapter. It was a national organization. Eventually that organization kind of disappeared. It disappeared pretty much nationally. But we as an interfaith subcommittee enjoyed meeting. And so we took what we did and all the programs that we did, and we just started our own organization, and we called it the Interfaith Council.
And the Interfaith Council is a group of individuals who put on a number of different events. And Ner Tamid has been part of those events since the beginning.
And I've been a part of that for over 30 years. And we have over a dozen different religions, lots of different religions on our council. And so one of the things that we try to do is, when times are good, get to know each other, understand each other, so that when times are not good, maybe there's an act of anti-Semitism, maybe there was an act of vandalism against the Sikh community, we want to be there to support each other and stand up and say, this is not acceptable, not in my town.
Nir Tamid has been a breath of fresh air for this community. Sandy, in my opinion, helped to bring spirituality to the Jewish community here in Southern Nevada. And he did that in a number of different ways, by starting a school, by helping to facilitate the growth of Nir Tamid, but most importantly, by being a person of real faith who was willing to reach out in goodwill to all other people, all other faiths, traditions, even pagans, even atheists, even agnostics.
We tie in to overall projects, interfaith projects. For example, Nevadans for the Common Good.
We are listening to members of our community, finding out what is impacting them, and looking at the power people that we need to talk to make a difference for the people in our community.
Historically, we've done an awful lot, ranging from Meals on Wheels, human and sex trafficking, payday loans, upgrading education in the area, people losing jobs.
I think by being involved in this, our voices are heard. And I think that's how these things get started. People are passionate about many, many different things. And if you bring it to the forefront and really start looking at it as a small committee, you can bring it to the larger committee.
All these different projects, which are from the grassroots up, are talked about within our congregation, and then we choose one or two issues a year that we focus on, and then we as a congregation try to affect change in the state legislature.
It's really important for each of us to support our religious communities. As we move into the 21st century, we need to create forums of conversation, and those forums of conversation rely upon one word, which is trust. It's about creating community, real community, because we're becoming a much smaller world right now, and we need each other more than ever before.
Congregation Nir Tamid would like to extend a special thank you to our gold sponsor for your continued support.
Another aspect of our role as a congregation is our commitment to bring the generations together, to spend time together, learning, and sharing our life experiences with each other.
One of the great values of Judaism is called the Dor V'Dor, which means from generation to generation. We came up with this program called a Friendly Visitors Program, where we not only have people visiting homebound seniors, but we take the next generation, the teens, and they come as well. And before you know it, there are natural friendships that form. The senior citizens feel valued because they are able to tell their story. And the young people get a sense of appreciation for the next generation that preceded them.
You need an intergenerational flow. You know, you get all jaded when you get older and you don't interact with the younger people who have the point of view of the present. They look at things with a fresh eye.
I think everyone should get to like be able to just connect with like people different and get to see what they like.
I like learning about how it once was with like out TVs, without phones.
We would be surprised if we went back and visited an elementary school or even a high school today. We might have our eyes open too.
Community needs to be inclusive. There's so much knowledge that our elders hold. And there's that knowledge from our youth as well. It's beautiful to know that this knowledge can be passed down from the elders to the youth and from the youth to the elders.
I look forward to doing this program and many other programs that bring our community closer together. The Dor V'Dor, not just a cliche, but a value embraced by Congregation Nir Tamid.
Congregation Nir Tamid really is a special place to belong. I love the community outreach programs, as well as the very creative services.
A highlight for all of us is when our services include our talented musical group, the Shabbatones. Here with us tonight to perform a number from their exciting and creative Beatles Shabbat, the Shabbatones.
Mm-hmm. A dangerous virus is spreading rapidly in China, and U.S. officials are very worried that it could come here.
Since Friday, the number of known infections across Asia has more than quadrupled.
Now to growing concerns about the deadly coronavirus officially hitting the U.S. Here's what we know.
We're really not sure where we are in this, and that's the reason why we say it's an evolving situation that we have to look at. It could go either way.
Today is a year, officially a year, that COVID was first came out and proved to be a problem.
You know, we had services every week. The Shabbatones played once a month. A lot of events happening, a lot of social events, educational activities.
And we're sitting here thinking, well, we had this before. We had the bird flu in Asia. We had, you know, swine flu. We'll just live on.
Nobody had even thought about that this would be a possibility, that everything would change almost on a dime.
Today it is clear additional steps must be taken immediately in order to slow the spread of this deadly virus in our state. I've spoken with the chief medical officers of all of Nevada's hospitals to get their assessment of our current situation and most responsible next steps. They have advised me that the most effective course of action is to direct all Nevadans to stay home and for non-essential businesses to close to the public for 30 days.
It was scary. It was very unknown. You know, being a physician, you like to see data unfold, what's real and what's not real.
So the COVID committee was formed relatively early in the pandemic, and it was to address the specific needs of the congregation.
Ira got myself, as well as Dr. Miller together, and the rabbi and the cantor, and we had to decide.
This is something that has to be tackled by committee to look at the trends and look at where COVID may be heading and enact or modify policies that the leadership can give to the congregation.
We had to do a lot of things virtually and avoid coming to services. We did try, we did open it up at one point to services, and I was like first to sign up, I came. And unfortunately, what I was concerned about happened, that people, I told the ushers, guide them to their seats, tell them to sit there, do your service and get out. This is unfortunately not a social event, but what happened? It became a social event. And that service, the rabbi actually was diagnosed with COVID right after that.
We had to realize that it was more important to keep people safe than it was to get people together.
What makes this congregation so great, because we like each other, is what also makes it so dangerous in the era of COVID, and we had to break through that.
I think that the congregants have been resilient regarding the realities of COVID and the need to be apart yet safe. And as vaccinations take place, and hopefully as the incidence of COVID goes down and we gradually get back together, I think it would almost be as if we had never left.
I want the congregation to understand that what we did was for the safety and health of our members. Maybe we were overly cautious, particularly in the beginning, because we didn't know, and we'd rather be safe than sorry. And you know, the last thing we wanted is something to happen, to have an outbreak in our congregation that got people quite ill or worse. So I thank the congregation for listening to what we had to say and understanding that we are doing this for them. And sometimes tough love is important, but it really was out of love.
As we have just heard, this past year really has been a challenging year for everybody. As president of the Mensch Club, we knew that our funds would be different in 2020 for CNT. With this in mind, the Mensch Club board agreed to reallocate our funds to be able to donate to the CNT COVID-19 Relief Project. We knew we had congregants in need and felt it was our responsibility to help. This was our opportunity to practice the principle of Tikkun Olam. We hope and pray that we will never face another situation like the COVID-19 pandemic.
But if we do, know that whatever happens, Congregation Near to Mead is here to help for everyone.
This last year has been horrible. It's very lonely to be alone. It's been the hardest thing I've ever done in my whole life.
With COVID-19, things have changed dramatically. The first thing that we did was put together a group called the CNT Connectors. So I put a list together of all of our congregants and had volunteers call each congregant on a weekly basis just to see how they were doing and if there was anything they needed.
In the last year, the congregation, they call and make sure you're okay. Very nice conversations. I think that's positive because you need to talk to somebody.
A lot of friendships were started with that, and we just learned so much more about congregants, and it brought us all closer together.
I have considered the congregation my second family. I watched the congregation every Friday night. Virtually, it's not as good as being there with somebody and talking to somebody, because the people at Near to Mead really are very friendly. And you walk in and they all say hello and so forth.
The doors here are open to anybody who needs solace, help in anything that they need. You have access to the rabbi, you have access to the cantor, to all of our clergy, and you have a wonderful listening ear from any one of us who works here. We all have that same feeling, and that's what makes it special.
It would be horrible to not have a Near to Mead. If you're having a problem and you call them up and you need something, this temple will stand by you. All you have to do is ask for it.
All of you watching from home tonight can help make a difference by making a donation. Simply text the number on your screen or visit the website below. There are still so many people in need of assistance, and we as a congregation can help.
We would like to thank those who have donated and continue to support the efforts of Congregation Near to Mead.
This year's recipient of the Justice Michael Cherry Tikkun Olam Award has been chosen because of her outstanding service to the community, the country, and to Congregation Near to Mead. Joining us to honor and celebrate this year's honoree, Senator Jackie Rosen, please welcome the host of the Jimmy Kimmel Show, Jimmy Kimmel.
Hi, I'm Jimmy Kimmel, talk show host and runner-up for People Magazine's Sexiest Man Alive 1998. I'm here tonight to congratulate Senator Rosen on this well-deserved honor. Jackie has devoted her life to Tikkun Olam, to the repairing of the world, both as the president of your temple and now as a member of Congress. Jackie believes that we should leave the world better than we found it. She stands up for others, whether it be her commitment to healthcare, the environment, civil rights, voting rights, education, and she only uses your space laser for good, never blasting pulses of high-energy electromagnetic radiation at her enemies. Jackie Rosen knows that building a better world requires cooperation, determination, and helping your fellow man, even when that fellow man thinks the pandemic is a hoax created by Antifa and Rachel Maddow. So congratulations, Senator Rosen. You are one in a million. I am proud to be your friend. Mazel tov.
When I hear the name Jackie Rosen, I think of a wonderful human being.
I think of a fun person who likes to laugh.
Jackie is fierce. She is loving. She is empathetic. She's a badass.
She has inspired myself, her team, the entire community, to really believe in the power of public service.
Energy. Personality. Dedication.
The Jackie you see on camera or at a committee, the same Jackie that you're going to see, you know, if you have a cup of coffee. She is who she is. She's bright, she's articulate, she's funny.
Jackie put so much passion into making Congregation Near to Mead a better place because Henderson needed it, right? Our community was growing. It was to give back, to repair the earth, to ensure that Judaism remains vibrant and flowing in Southern Nevada.
Jackie was a perennial board member, and as such, she held every major chairmanship.
Well, Jackie became president of the synagogue because she is extremely capable. And I think everybody realized that. They saw the way she empowers people. They saw the way she encourages people, gets people together, and is not afraid of tackling a big task and making that task happen from start to finish.
I can remember every Sunday morning, her being outside at Carline for drop-off of Sunday school. And she, I don't know if you know this, but Jackie has the gift of gab. Like, she can talk. And so you would have this car line, people would be dropping them off, or she would have coffee. She actually implemented having coffee and pastry, so when parents would drop off, they would like stay and they would talk to each other and they would build this community. And it's something that I think I really learned a lot from, is that that personal connection, how important that is.
One of the great things is she would find talent within the congregation. It wasn't just all Jackie. She would find people, and she was as one of the great connectors. And she would say, so-and-so, do you know so-and-so? So-and-so, do you know so-and-so? And around the time when she was president came the idea of, we have a huge power bill. What if somehow we could go on solar energy? Impossible, it's too expensive. They found a grant, over $1 million grant. And we are now a congregation that stands not just for lowering power bills, but for solar energy and reducing our carbon footprint, and to saying to the community, because we're right off the 215, and they look there and they go, wow, this is a huge project.
Jackie was responsible for bringing our current Cantor to Ne'er Ta Mead, and that was a game changer. I didn't realize chanting and praying could be such a beautiful thing. And I think finding this gem of a Cantor in Jessica has really changed the whole metamorphosis of Ne'er Ta Mead into this really young, vibrant, welcoming, inclusive community of mostly Jewish people.
A funny thing happened during her presidency. She was approached to run for Congress.
She was approached by a fellow congregant who had been previously approached.
She said, well, I would probably have to leave the presidency a few months early. I said, Jackie, this is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. The temple needs you, but the world needs you. I mean, how often do you get to say that cliche, right? But it's true.
My phone rang, and it's Jackie. And Jackie says to me, I am thinking about running for the United States Congress. She says, I can't believe that I was approached and people would think that I would be able to do the job, but nobody would know that better than you. What do you think? Immediately, I thought, this is remarkable. She would be perfect.
Against the odds, She ran. She turned out to be a natural campaigner. And she ran for Congress and won. And when there was an opening in the Senate, again, the stars aligned. Fabulous campaigner. She was able to get her message through. And now she's in the Senate.
Senator Rosen, among so many of her many accomplishments, was the co-founder of the task force to combat anti-Semitism. And that has just garnered so much traction. And for all the right reasons, because we have seen the rise in anti-Semitism, and she's really stepped up.
Having an elected official like Jackie Rosen amplifies everything that we are, not just as a community, but as a state, right? And being able to have a Jewish congresswoman who understands the needs and the wants and the struggles of our community, of all communities, who understands that anti-Semitism is the canary in the coal mine, who understands the importance of all of these things coming together to help one another.
We needed a strong voice in the United States Senate. Jackie Rosen has risen to the occasion, and she is now synonymous with fighting anti-Semitism, not only in Nevada, not only in the United States, but throughout the world.
when the committee met and we go, who should we honor this year? It took us about 3 seconds to say, Jackie Rosen. Of course it should be Jackie. Not only are we proud of her and what she stands for, but it's what she fights for. She fights for Tikkun Olam. In repairing the world, she is there as a voice for our community, our congregation, and for our state.
Mom, I'm so excited to be with you tonight to watch you receive this award. As everyone has just shared, you are an incredible person who really has affected so many people's lives. You've always been this amazing person, and I'm just so happy you're really receiving recognition for your fantastic achievements and all of your efforts. You are an incredible person, and I'm so proud of everything you do for our family, for the synagogue community, for the country, and for the world. I love you so much, and I'm so proud of you today and always.
Hello, I'm U.S. Senator Catherine Cortez Masto, and I am happy to join you in congratulating my friend and colleague, Senator Jackie Rosen, for receiving the Tikkun Olam Award from the Congregation Neir Tamid. After working alongside Senator Rosen for the past 2 years, I can confidently say that she embodies this award's ideal. Her unwavering passion to serve the people of Nevada and tireless battle against anti-Semitism make me so proud to work alongside her every single day. Jackie, thank you for everything you do for Nevadans, and congratulations for receiving this great award. You deserve it, my friend.
Clearly, Senator Jackie Rosen is an incredible person and has touched the hearts of so many. A true champion for her family, her faith, her community, and her country. Much like the commitment and passion of Senator Rosen, our next guest literally took the Broadway stage by storm, starring as Alexander Hamilton in the hit Broadway musical, Hamilton. Please welcome the incredibly talented Miguel Cervantes.
Hey everybody, how you doing? My name is Miguel Cervantes, your friendly neighborhood A.Ham from the Broadway production of Hamilton. I'd like to offer my congratulations to Senator Rosen on being this year's honoree. I am honored to be here with you to celebrate this amazing day. So thank you so, so much for having me. And to celebrate, I would like to sing you a song. Now, the official title of this song is called A Ham Jam. Well, the word got around. They said this kid is insane, man. Took up a collection just to send him to the mainland. Get your education, don't forget from whence you came. And the world's gonna know your name. What's your name, man? Alexander Hamilton. My name is Alexander Hamilton. And there's a million things I haven't done. But just you wait, just you wait. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Imagine death so much it feels more like a memory. When's it gonna get me in my sleep? 7 feet ahead of me. If I see it coming, do I run or do I let it be? Is it like a beat without a melody? See, I never thought I'd live past 20. Where I come from, some get half as many. Ask anybody why we're living fast. And we laugh, reach for a flask. We have to make this moment last, and that's plenty. Scratch that, this is not a moment, it's the movement. We're all the hungriest brothers with something to prove. When foes oppose us, we take an honest stand. We roll like Moses, claiming our promised land. And if we win our independence, is that a guarantee of freedom for our descendants? Or would the blood we shed begin an endless cycle of vengeance and death with no defendants? Let me tell you what I wish I'd known when I was young and dreamed of glory. You have no control who lives, who dies, who tells your story. I know that we can win. I know that greatness lies in you. But remember, from here on in, history has its eyes on you. Whoa, 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 whoa. History has its eyes on you. Whoa, 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 whoa. Yeah. I'm past patiently waiting. I'm past passionately smashing every expectation, every action's an act of creation. I'm laughing in the face of casualties and sorrow. For the first time, I'm thinking past tomorrow, and I am not throwing away my shot. I am not throwing away my shot. Hey yo, I'm just like my country. I'm young, scrappy, and hungry, and I'm not throwing away my shot. I am not throwing away my shot. No, I'm not throwing away my shot. Hey yo, I'm just like my country. I'm young, scrappy, and hungry, and I'm not throwing away my shot. Whoa, 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 whoa.
The spirit of Tikkun Olam, the repairing of the world, is in essence the core of public service. And it's really integrally what Jackie is about. Her journey from community leader to systems analyst to synagogue president to congresswoman and ultimately to United States senator has been very successful, in part because of the sincerity, generosity, and compassion that she brings to all of her roles. I was able to stand by her through this whole journey and see her personal growth as a wife, a beloved mother, a community leader, and a member of Congress. It really is an inspiring story, and she's just getting started. Every day when I see the energy and enthusiasm that she brings to her life, I'm tired just watching her. She truly is deserving of this award. I love you, Jackie, and we're all so proud of you.
Thank you for those wonderful tributes to our honoree and that incredible performance. Congregation Near to Mead recognizes the importance of preparing the next generation for the future. It is my pleasure to introduce you to Clayton Greb.
Hi, I'm Clayton Greb. I've had the privilege of growing up here at Congregation Near Talmud. As a student of the religious school, I've learned what it means to be Jewish in today's modern world, as well as the traditions and history of Judaism. These principles and values I've learned have helped shape me as a young adult and has prepared me for the future. As a senior in high school, I recognize the importance of the school, and I'm grateful for my time at CNT.
I think it's a great place for the kids because I think the teachers care very much that the kids will have a meaning in their life.
As a child grows at Near to Mead, they begin in preschool and then go all the way through their senior year in high school.
In seventh grade, we teach tzedakah, social action, and anti-Semitism. When they're having conversations with their peers, they're able to understand and have a discussion on what it means to them.
I actually got to go to a Yom HaShoah service where I got to meet up with some amazing Holocaust survivors who had such inspirational stories. The older these people get, the less you're gonna get to meet them. And the more important it is that the people who could are learning all they can and not being too scared to shy away from what's being taught.
I'm a student, so I go to Hebrew school on Tuesdays. I also participate in Sheer Heart, which Jessica started.
I like singing because it lets me be me, it lets me experiment with my voice, and when you sing, you can meet so many amazing people.
It brings me a lot of pride to look next to me and see this young person who is growing into their own and has taken the responsibility of leading the congregation Lador Vador from generation to generation.
I like working with cancer because she makes it fun. It's not just like, oh, I have to work on my bat mitzvah. It's like fun, like I want to work on my bat mitzvah. I want to practice, like I'm excited for my bat mitzvah.
I love all the people here at the synagogue. They're such great people. And my cantor is such an amazing person.
I get the question very often, cantor, why am I doing this? From a child. And this is our tradition, which seems like such a basic answer. But it's not so simple. We are free to be who we are. For the first time in history, that is our opportunity. And if we don't choose to live that tradition and pass it down, it'll be lost forever.
The thing I'm looking forward to most on my bat mitzvah is I've always seen like the rabbi wear a tali. I've always seen the cantor wear a tali. I'm showing I'm being a Jew by wearing a tali. And so I'm excited to get mine.
I love working with young people because you just see hope. Through their eyes, you can see what's possible. And there's just something so inspiring about that. And if you really listen and you really watch, you get to see what tomorrow is going to look like.
I see it as planting like a seed. You know, we're enjoying fruits of the trees that were planted before us, and I am planting the seed that the generation after them will enjoy. I think we also have a responsibility as a community to understand that the school, the synagogue, is not something we take for granted. If you want this to be here for you, make sure it is.
It is invaluable to who you are and who you become. You will learn not only the rituals, but what it means to be a good person. This is who we are, and you can't fully shape yourself as a human being from Jewish lineage without this part of your education.
We learn a lot here at Congregation Near Talmid, and we also have a lot of fun. Joining us now is a friend of our congregation who knows all about having fun. He is one of the most popular contestants to ever appear on America's Got Talent, currently performing his own show at the Flamingo Hotel and Casino right here in Las Vegas. Please welcome Piff the Magic Dragon.
Hello, it's me, Piff the Magic Dragon, here for the Takum Alam Award Ceremony. I got that right? Yeah, nailed it. Honoring Senator Jackie Rosen. Now, I thought it might be nice to do a magic trick. Unfortunately, you're so far away, it's redundant, and I desperately need 3 coins. What's that? You've got some. Boom. Oh, look, I just plucked them from the internet. That's right, 1 coin over here. These are Morgan silver dollars. You see them? I got them from my nice friend Neil, who runs the gold store on Jones and Flamingo. Coin number 2 over here. And coin number 3. We're going to make them travel from one hand to the other with my little dragon sleeves rolled up. You ready to watch coin number 1? Here we go, coin number 1. Oh, bang, it went. How about that, son? 1 down, 3 to go. That's right, it's gonna happen 3 more times. You've got 3 chances to catch me. What do you mean, 3, Piff? There are only 2 coins left. Boom, where they're gonna go, and they're gonna come back. Oh, what, and then they're gonna go again. This one, you might catch this one, you, because it's I just did it in front of your face. Boom, it came back again. Watch the final coin, from here to here. 1, 2, 3. 3 coins. Boom, I just ate them.
Thanks, Piff. That was great. Before we present the Takum Alam Award, we have another special guest standing by who is very excited to join us tonight.
Hello, everybody. This is United States Senator Cory Booker. I tried to be president, but I failed. But I want to talk right now about somebody who has shown presidential timber, who has attained that title of president. No, it's not Joe Biden. It is my colleague, Jackie Rosen, who's been an amazing shul president, synagogue president. And more than that, she is someone who is so worthy of your recognition for the Michael Cherry Takum Alam Award. There are deep values within the Jewish faith that are universal values, that are the highest ideals of humanity. They're seen in words like chesed and tzedakah, this idea of grace and charity, this idea of justice, kindness. These are the values that are the core of my colleague. She is someone that understands what Hillel says. If I am not for myself, who will be for me? If I am only for myself, what am I? If not now, when? She shows that heroic empathy, that urgent cause of justice. She is a servant leader and knows that you can't lead the people if you don't love the people. Her love is not sentimentality. It is sacrifice. It is service. She is in struggle for the larger cause of our country. Now, I may be in physical stature a little bit taller than her, but as someone who sits next to her on the Senate floor, I'm going to tell you, when she stands, I look up to her. Because she always stands up for her state, for her nation. She stands for the vulnerable. She stands for the hurt. She stands for those who are facing injustice. She stands for righteousness. And I'll tell you this, at the March on Washington, this profound culmination of the struggles and sacrifices to push legislation through the then United States Senate, the 1964 Civil Rights Act, 65 Voting Rights Act. This was one of our great moments where Blacks and Jews joined together in a larger rainbow coalition. During that time, the March on Washington, we know King spoke, but there was a rabbi from my community, a rabbi from Newark, New Jersey, Rabbi Prince, who stood before King and gave an amazing speech where he said, and I will quote, he said that bigotry and hatred are not the most urgent problem. The most urgent, the most disgraceful, the most shameful and most tragic problem is silence. I want to celebrate tonight someone that is healing this world through her voice, through her work, through her standing up and speaking up and working every single day to make sure that we heal, that we help, that we stand in unity and common cause and common purpose for a better nation and a better world. Thank you, Jackie. I'm honored to be your colleague, and even more so, to be your friend. Congratulations on this well-deserved honor. Yashar Koach, my friend. Yashar Koach.
Thank you, Senator Booker. And now to present the Justice Michael Cherry Tikkun Olam Award, please welcome Justice Michael Cherry and Congregation President Gerald Gordon.
Thank you, Jeff. And as we come to the culmination of this wonderful evening, I'd first like to introduce the Honorable Michael Cherry, past president of Congregation Unity Mead, for whom this award is named. Michael.
Thank you, Jerry. Congratulations, Jackie. Mazel tov to Senator Rosen. You and I go back to our work with the Jewish Federation, and then we were assigned to go over to the Jewish Family Service to do some work over there. And I was so impressed with your community service work. And it's such an honor for me to have shared being a past president with you of Congregation Near to Mead, which is so dear to your heart and my heart. Also, I'm so glad and honored that you're accepting this award, this Community Service Award, in my name. Jackie, God bless you. God bless your family. Please stay safe. Jerry?
Thank you, Michael. Jackie, your dedication to Congregation Near to Mead and your significant work as a U.S. Senator is emblematic of Tikkun Olam. I am proud to be here tonight, along with Justice Cherry, to award you the Michael Cherry Tikkun Olam Award.
Thank you, Mike, and thank you, Jerry. And I want to thank everybody for all the kind words that they've said, everything that has transpired so far this evening, because I'll tell you, this award means so much to me. And Mike, there's no better person than for this award to be named after, because Tikkun Olam, doing good deeds, repairing the world, it's something you've spent your life doing. And I feel incredibly privileged. Throughout my life, my father, when I was a young girl, would always tell me, if you were blessed, you should always give back. And so when I came to Nevada and I started getting involved in my community, and I've been a member of Congregation Near to Mead for nearly 30 years, I've volunteered, I've done so many things, I've always gotten more out of that than what I gave. And what I learned from that, we think about this from synagogue to the Senate, we think about our shared commitment, our shared values of making the world a better place. What I learned, what I take with me every day, is that every person wants to matter. They want to count. They want to do something good. They care about their friends and their family. They want to honor the people who came before them and do good for the ones who came after. Tikkun Olam, whether they know those words or not, that's what everyone here knows. That's what we do. And I take those same values with me every day to the United States Senate. And so whether our work is large or small, we know that if we touch one life, just one life, and we make it better, then we've changed it for that entire family. And so you have to think of everything you do in that context for people you may know or those you don't, that the work continues. You honor those who came before you. You think about those after. You do good work. Tikkun Olam. It never stops, and I'm so appreciative and grateful for you all to honor me this evening. Thank you.
Congratulations, Senator Jackie Rosen, and a special thank you to all of our celebrity guests and friends for joining us tonight. We are grateful to our congregants, community, and to our supporters throughout the country for your donations. I look forward to seeing you next year, not virtually, but in person. Until then, let each of us continue to practice the principle of Tikkun Olam and to do our part in repairing the world. I'm Jeff Lebo. Thank you and good night.
Thinking of all those mitzvot, yeah. Chayenu ve'orech yameinu, v'hem nege yomam v'lada. That Torah's always on my mind. Show me this Shabbat, your everlasting love. Didn't miss your people, Yisrael. Teaching Torah mitzvot. Rejoicing in